Hey guys, welcome back to the channel and I'm Dinesh here and this is my YouTube channel. In case if you're new to my channel, then I make tech videos here and then some car videos. So if you are into it, make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell icon as well. So only then you'll get the notification whenever I upload a new video. So now we'll get into the matter of this video. So in this video, I'll be upgrading this Lenovo laptop's RAM and then internal storage. So I'll be upgrading the RAM from 4 gigs to 8 gigs and then I'll be adding an extra SSD to this laptop. So it already has a hard disk in it. I'll be slotting in an SSD also so that the performance will improve significantly. So now this laptop is actually my dad's laptop. So this is not mine. So I have actually done an upgrade video for my laptop, but I did that video in Tamil. So most of you guys have commented in that video that to make a video in English. So here this video, I'm making it in English. So now I'll tell about this laptop first. So this is a professional laptop actually. So the specs are very decent and it's actually for professionals, not for gaming purpose or productivity purpose. So this laptop has an i5-6th-gen mobile processor in it and then it has 4 gigs of RAM, so which can be upgraded up to 16 GB. And then it has a 500 GB hard disk and then a disk drive also. So this is the basic specs of this laptop and it also has an integrated graphics. So Intel's integrated graphics. So this one doesn't have an dedicated graphic card. So now I'll be upgrading the laptop's RAM. So I'll be upgrading it from 4 GB to 8 GB. So this RAM is a DDR3, so not DDR4. This is actually a 5-year-old laptop and so 5 years before most of the laptops I think had DDR3, so this one has a DDR3 RAM in it. And then I'm going to take this disk drive out and throw it into trash and then I'm going to put in an SSD into this disk drive slot. So who uses CD in 2021? So now right here, these are the things that we are going to put into this laptop. So this is a 240 GB SSD from Crucial and this is the extra 4 gigs of RAM that we are going to slot into this laptop. And then this is the case, so we are going to put this SSD into this case and then slot it into the disk drive. So now these are the things which I bought, and this SSD and this case, both of these were bought from Amazon, and this SSD actually had a very good reviews from its buyers. So I bought this SSD from Crucial. And you can also buy it from Western Digital's green SSD. So that one also has a very good ratings in Amazon. And then this RAM was bought from Flipkart. So Flipkart was cheaper than Amazon. So I bought this RAM from Hynix because the RAM which was already present inside this laptop was from Hynix. So I bought it from the same brand. So make sure that you check the frequency of the RAM before buying it. And the version also, whether it's DDR3 or DDR4. So mine is DDR3 and it has a frequency of 1666 MHz. So look into the frequency before buying it. So now I'll give the links to buy all these things in the description below. So go check it out. So the price may vary in the future. I bought this SSD for 2500 rupees and this for 200 rupees and then the RAM for 1320 rupees. So my total cost was just under 4000 rupees. So now we'll start with upgrading the RAM. We'll switch off the system first and then we'll get to the back of the laptop. So here in this older laptops, they actually provide this backdoor to upgrade the RAM or the hard disk. But in the newer laptops, especially the portable ones, since they are designed in a compact manner, the manufacturers, they can't provide these backdoor panels in the portable laptops. So they are a bit difficult to get into this new portable laptops to upgrade their RAM or SSD. But in these chunkier old ones, we can just open up this back cover and slot in the RAM, and you can also change the hard disk. Now we'll open up this back of the laptop with this tools kit which I have. So before opening up, we'll actually pull out the battery out of this laptop. So battery is also present externally. which makes it very easy to swap the battery in case this battery is dead in the future. So that's also an advantage with the older chunkier laptops. In current laptops, you can't actually do these kind of things. So now I'm going to open up this back door panel. So you just have to slide it. Now it gets open. So here, this is the hard disk, and then this is the RAM slot. So we already have a 4 gigs of RAM here in this slot. I'm going to slot in this extra 4 gigs which I bought into this slot. See, it's dead easy. In for my Asus FX570, I had to dismantle the whole laptop to get access to this motherboard. So this is the RAM. I'm going to put in. So I'm going to slot in it. Yeah, that's it. Simple. So you'll hear a click sound. So that means your RAM is inserted properly. Now we'll close off this. We have no other work here. We'll close it off. So that's it. That's it. Now we need to upgrade the SSD. So before actually putting this SSD into this laptop, we have to put this SSD into this case first, and then only we can slot this case into the disk tray slot. So now we are going to assemble this one first, and then we'll get to the laptop. So until then, we'll keep this aside. Now we'll open this SSD. So this SSD actually has a 3 years warranty, so you no need to worry for 3 years in case this SSD fails. Crucial has it covered. So we have these screws and then a screwdriver. Actually, that's nice. You get all these things for 200 rupees. That's actually great. And one more thing. So before ordering these case, you should check the disk drive size of your laptop. So before ordering it, make sure to check that. So I'll tell you how to check the size of your disk drive.
You're going to type device manager on the search. You're going to open device manager, and here you can see DVD CD-ROM. You're going to press on it, and here on the last you can see its model number, GU90N. Your will be different based on whichever DVD ROM you have on your laptop. So I'm going to write GU90N, that is the model number of my DVD ROM, on Google, and I'm going to search for it. So you can see different things come up, and here is the Dell website. You can open this, it will show you the thickness, and you can see other websites as well. 9.5 mm, NHL New, HL 9.5 mm, GU90. This is the model, and if I open it, here you can see internal drive for Dell, as my laptop is Dell, so I'm really sure that this is the DVD ROM that is installed on my laptop, and this is the main thing.
Only after seeing the size of the disk drive, you order it from Amazon or Flipkart. So that's the great idea. And then now that's it. You just have to slot in it like this. So now I have slotted in the SSD into this case. So after that, you have to screw this SSD to this case. Only then it won't move around after you put it inside the laptop. So put on this four screws which are provided along with the case. So now we have assembled SSD with this case. Now we are going to open up this laptop and pull out the disk drive. So now pulling out this disk drive is also dead simple. You just have to unscrew the screw over here, and then just pull the disk drive out. It'll just come out. So this one is also dead easy. Now we'll keep this laptop aside. Check the size, both of the size first. So I think both of these are similar in size. So now we should have no problem putting in this SSD into the disk drive slot. So before putting in this SSD into the laptop, we are going to take this hook, put it into this one. So only then you can keep this drive in place inside the laptop. So we are going to unscrew this hook from the disk drive and then screw it down here in this place. So only then this SSD can be in place inside the laptop without moving here in the when you're carrying your laptop.
So now what you have to do is make sure that you take this plastic outer cover from this disk drive. So this is the outer cover which you'll have with the disk drive. So make sure to take that out from the disk drive. So we are going to insert the outer cover from the disk drive to this caddy. This is not necessary for the laptop to perform properly. This is just to make the laptop look clean after inserting this SSD into it. So now after inserting the outer cover from the disk drive to the caddy, we are going to insert this caddy into the laptop. So make sure that this port is aligned with the port inside the laptop and then slot it in. So. So that's it, it's dead simple. Then we'll insert the screw and screw it down.
Now that's it. Now I'm going to slot in the battery here. That's it. In order to take the full potential of the SSD's fastness, you have to install the Windows onto this SSD and then use the hard disk for saving huge data, and then install all your applications onto the SSD. Only then you'll get the snappiness while using the Windows. So that's it regarding this video, guys. The main objective of this video is to make my laptop work a lot more faster. So the laptop is actually almost 5 years old now, and actually in 21 with the 4 gigs of RAM, it felt a lot slower even for web browsing and then for checking an email. So my dad was a bit frustrated with the performance of the laptop. So then I jumped in and I told him that we'll do an upgrade for the laptop. And now I have upgraded it from 4 gigs to 8 gigs of RAM. And then I also slotted in an SSD along with the hard disk, which already existed in the laptop. So now the laptop feels a lot more faster and a lot more smoother and responsive to use. And now my father actually loves using it. So it's actually almost 5 years old now, but even now with the upgradation of SSD and RAM, the laptop is almost usable in 21 even after 5 years with just these minor upgrades for just 4000 rupees. So that's it regarding this video. If you like this video, make sure to hit the like button, and in case if you are new to my channel, make sure to hit the subscribe button. That will help me to improve this channel a lot more in the future, and it also encouraged me to do a lot more videos like this. And then hit the bell icon as well. Only then you'll get a notification whenever I upload a video. So thanks for watching. Catch you guys in the next video.